It's always fun to do these examples and then realize that somebody could just walk in and look at this and go, what in the world is going on with this example? But this is the point I want to kind of drive home here. Why do we do 2's complement that way? Why not just represent that first bit as a 1 or a 0 and then count it? And I think it has been done that way in the past. I guess I'm guessing on that. Can't say for sure. But somebody came up with this kind of ingenious little way of storing this as a negative number. So this is in 2's complement a negative number. And so I'm just going to take that number and write it up here in our conversion. So we had a 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so that is a negative 25 in binary. Wow, struggling to find the word there. There's got to be a better way to erase. Can I just drag this? No, I can't. We'll pause for a second. Ta-da! Okay, so that's a negative 25. And let's say that we take to a negative 25, and let's convert, what is a 30? Run out of space here. Oh, I got my eraser on still. So let's say, what's a 30 in base 10 in binary? Okay, well, we can go through the same process. So these are the 1s, 2s, 4s, 8s, 16, 32. And so we don't need a 32, it's too big. A 30 then is going to be a 16. Can I get a 5 in there? Yeah, I can. That'll be 21, 25, 16 plus 5 is 21, 25, 27, 28. What am I doing wrong here? Did I skip a number? 32. Sixteen plus five is 21. 25, 27. All right, let's pause for one more second while I think about this. All right, you're probably laughing at me because I got bit by my own handwriting. See, I should have done better in elementary school in handwriting. That should be an 8. Holy cow. 16 plus 8, let's try that. 24, 28, 30. And so a 30 in binary is a 11110. Okay. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to say, let's take a 30. So a 11101. So 11110. Okay. And I'm going to take this 30 and I'm going to extend it out to 16 bits, just like we did with the other number. Again, that's really dependent on the size of the bus. I just don't want you to have to write too many zeros. Okay, so there's 16 bits. So this is a 30, right? What happens now if I add the 30 and the 25? So I've got a 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay? I'm going to add those two numbers together. So that's the 30. This is the negative 25 using 2's complement. So a 0 plus a 1 is a 1. A 1 plus a 1 is a 0. Carry the 1. A 1 plus a 1 plus a 1 is going to be a 1. Carry the 1, right? Because we get 1 plus 1 is 0, is 1, 0. Plus another 1 is 1, 1, so I get the 1, carry the 1. 1 plus 1 plus 0 is a 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 1 is a 0, carry the 1. 0, carry the 1, 0, carry the 1, 0, carry the 1. 0 carry the 1, 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 0 carry the 1. Now this part's important. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, but I'm out of bus. There's nowhere else for me to go. There's no other bits. The bus is only 16 bits in this case, or 32 bits in real life, or 64 bits. And so what happens to that one that I just carried? It falls off into oblivion. And we're left with this number, which is a what? Well, we've got a 4 plus a 1 is a 5. So 30 minus 25 is 5. And it works. If you aren't jumping up and down right now, you got something wrong with you. Okay, not really. But that's why we store it that way, because if we store it this way, then all we need to do, so picture in memory, these numbers are being stored. And then when I need to add them together, I can just add them. I don't have to go and convert anything or do anything tricky. I've already done that on the front end to convert the number. Now it's just stored as a negative 25. When I add these two numbers together, it comes out with the correct equivalent. Okay, and that's why the size of the bus is so important. Make sure you do that. So the steps are, for 2's complement, convert to the positive number. So convert negative 25 to a positive. Extend that number out to the length of the bus, okay, which we did here, I'll identify that. As you're doing a problem, I guess assume it's 32 bits unless otherwise noted, but like I said, I want to keep it to 16 bits. So I extended out to 16 bits. I added 1, so there's the 16 bit. I added 1, and I got this number, which is the negative 25 stored in 2's complement. Okay, then it's stored in a way that if I add it together, I'll get the correct result. Just maybe one last thought on all this. I know this is a lot of stuff, but if I get a number like this, positive 25, and want to convert that to binary in 2's complement, well, remember that 0 at the beginning of the number represents that it's a positive number. So all I need to do to make this work, I can still go through the same process of converting it. 1s, 2s, 4s, 8s, 16s. Notice how clearly I wrote that 8. Okay, so I don't need that. 16, 1, 8, 1, takes 24, and then a 1. Okay, so but I need to make sure that I got that 0 out front, so it's going to be like this. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay? So this number right here indicates that it's a positive number. Now, truthfully, we don't need to have all these numbers. We can just leave it as 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, because if they're not on, they're off, right? And just like in a decimal positive number, if I have a number like 28, I can strip off these leading zeros just like I did up here, and it doesn't affect the number. But I just wanted to point that out. If I ask you for a positive 2's complement number, it's just a normal conversion like we'd regularly do. Okay, hopefully that's interesting. So just a few odds and ends to cover, and then we'll be done. Spencer out.